Hi everyone and welcome back. Welcome to another video which will help you to prepare for JavaScript interviews. Okay, so in this video we are going to talk about some part of functional programming. Okay, what are the functional programming aspects in JavaScript. Okay, so first let's talk about it. So functional programming is a concept of building a software by composing a pure function, avoiding shared state, mutable data and side effects. Okay, so here we will talk about few different terms and this we will discuss about it. Shared state. Okay, these are actually just a different terms which we use. So we have to be familiar with these terms before going into the functional programming. So how question comes, they will directly ask you what is a pure function, what is immutability, what all different options to have the immutability, like what all different utility methods which JavaScript already having. Okay, so let's talk about one by one. So functional programming always abbreviated as a FP. Functional programming is a paradigm. It's like a programming paradigm, meaning that it is a way of thinking about software construction based on some fundamental definitions like immutability, pure functions, and choosing declarative programming or imperative programming, right? So all these things. So first thing we will talk about is pure functions, functional composition, avoiding a shared state, avoiding and mutating a data directly, avoiding the side effects. Okay. So these things we are going to talk about, and our main discussions will be on these. So first of all, let's talk about pure function. Pure function is a function which gives the same input, always returns the same output, and has no side effect. Okay, pure function has a lot of properties that are important in a functional programming, including referential transparency. You can replace a function call with its resulting value without changing the meaning of program. Okay, so a pure function is a simple function which gives you always same output if you keep giving the same input, simple addition function, right? It doesn't have any kind of side effect. It is not doing any kind of operation, asynchronous operation. And it is not mutating the state, or it is not accessing the external state. The output of the function depends on the input you are passing. If the input is same, the output is going to be the same always. So like simple function we write is x a comma b, and what you are doing a plus b. I can call this function as a pure function because with the given input a and b, it will always return the same output. And the concept pure functions are popular at many places. Like if you talk about Redux, there we have pure functions. What those functions are, those functions deal with the core data. No asynchronous operation, you give the input, they will give the output. From input A and B, 1 and 1, I can predict the output of this will be 2. A is 1, B is 1, then output of this function will always be 2. So it's like a predictable state. They take the input and they will return always you can say a new state. They don't do any kind of side effect dealing with any kind of data. Okay. Now, next thing we are talking about is immutability. So this also is popular in JavaScript, like how we can make our data structure immutable. There is already an immutable JS for doing the same thing, which is actually freezing the object, where we have a lot of collections like list, map and all as a immutable data structure. But in JavaScript also you can actually make the object freeze, which will put their writable properties as a false and you can't update the value. Okay, now immutability means when you are reading a function, like simple function is this function hello, and you are taking an object as an input, and what you are doing is in this you are doing object dot x is 90 and return object. So what you end up doing is you are passing one object and you are updating that object, right? Means you are actually mutating the state of object which is being passed to you. Instead of this function, if I try to write const copy, if I create a copy of this object by just using spread operator or object.assign, and then I will just say object dot x is, sorry, copy dot x is, and I will just return the copy. That is an immutable way of dealing these functions, right? Because I'm not updating the existing properties, right? I'm not mutating the existing. So there is an immutable JS and some other libraries are available. Okay, so we were talking about immutability, and here we can talk about other examples, like what all different methods are there. So whenever you wanted to create a copy of an array, then you can just simply do array.map and filter. All these methods are actually not updating the existing array, not manipulating the existing array. They are always creating a new array. You can also do array1 equal to, you can also do spread operator, and you can copy it something like this. Okay, or you, instead of map, you can do the filter. It will also return the new array, or you can do a slice. It will do a deep copy of this. I mean, we are not passing any argument, so it will create a whole copy of, and it will give us the new array. And if we talk about this, then the other options we have is object.assign, which will do the shallow copy. I mean, it will create a new object from the object which you have passed. If the object is a not nested object, then it will do a deep copy. But if object is a nested object, then it will do a shallow copy. And this is same as you are actually spreading the object and then giving it back. Okay, so there are multiple options, or you can also use immutable JS to achieve this functionality. Now let's talk about declarative and imperative. Another concept of a functional programming. So what do we call it as an imperative, or what we call as a declarative? Imperative programs spends line of code describing the specific steps used to achieve that particular result. When I say imperative means, here we are explaining. So even if there is a loop we are iterating onto array, we are explicitly like explaining, okay, we took the number, we did the for loop, we actually did the push, and then we are returning the new array. Instead of this, when we are doing a declarative programming doesn't, declarative programming does the same thing but abstract the flow. It hides the implementation, underlying implementation. Now, if you look at the map, filter, reduce, all these methods, whatever we are using, it is not extending or explaining, okay, we are iterating, we are looping onto the array, and then we are actually multiplying each and every element with 2 and returning the new array. It is actually hiding it. It is actually hiding the abstract of the flow or the control, right? So in imperative code, frequently utilize the statement as statement is a piece of code. And the common example of those statements is for loop, if, throw, switch, continue, break, all these kind of things. Where we are talking about these declarative, which actually abstract the implementation, we are using them, object.assign, map, filter, reduce, slice, all these methods. So from the overall discussions like imperative, declarative, how you should write pure functions, how you should mutate the state while writing the functions, do not directly mutate, always create a copy and then do the mutation on top of it, right? So the conclusion of functional programming favors pure functions instead of shared state and side effects. And what we are calling side effects, anything which is happening, I mean, you are doing a network call, or you are actually writing to the network, writing to file, all these things are considered as a side effect in terms of JavaScript language. Side effect is anything which is happening asynchronous over the time. Okay, so our functional programming favors pure functions, immutability over the mutable data or mutable state, functional composition over imperative flow control, declarative rather than the imperative code, okay, and a lot of reusable utilities that use higher order functions, all those things are favored by the functional programming. You can actually look at how we do the map, filter, reduce, all these methods. A simple map we have used many times. So this is items, right? We are doing item.map, it is returning the empty object, right? So here, if you want it, you take the item and whatever you wanted to do with item, like you are returning only item.name. So in the new object, new array, you will have only name. Similarly, here you can do the filter. Here what we are doing is I dot point points, if that is greater than 3, then only return that, right? So it is not changing the original array or object, it is always returning the new one. Similarly, we have a reduce which returns one single output whenever. So reduce is kind of same here. Instead of filter, you can do the reduce, which will take a callback functions and the value which you are going to initialize, empty object or something else. Okay, so these are all different examples to talk more about the functional programming. Let's talk another topics for JavaScript interviews in the next video, like JavaScript basic core questions.